Welcome everyone today to today's webinar on SharePoint Online. This today's topic is stay on top of SharePoint Online changes. First of all, we'll thank to CSOP Corner and CSOP Corner Chennai chapter lead Mr. Santa Kumar Munaswamy for providing this opportunity and organizing this event. Myself, Santa Kumar, and I have 10 years experience on SharePoint. I am a SharePoint enthusiast and have written a lot of blogs and videos. So today we'll see the most recently available changes in SharePoint Online. Today's agenda is, first we'll be going to see the SharePoint Modern Online Admin Center. I think you have already seen the SharePoint Modern Pages and Modern Sites, and recently they have introduced the Admin Center also in a modern UI. We'll see what are the features available in Modern Online Admin Center. And then we'll be seeing on the latest or recently changes available in a modern list and library. There are a lot of things of added to the modern list, like attention views and predictive indexing and column formatting and creating new columns in a modern way. And then we'll be going to see the sharing improvements. What are the SharePoint Online, how we can share the sharing the items to external users or sharing the documents to external users is a lot of improved, and we can enable the anonymous links. Even though if you have a Google Gmail account or any kind of email, you no need to log in with Microsoft account to view the page or document in SharePoint. So we'll going to see one by one in a cool demo. First, we'll going to see what are the features and available, how it is enabled, and how we can view those features in SharePoint Online Admin Center. Okay. First is going to see what are the features available in the Modern Admin Center homepage. First, when you log into the Admin Center, you'll be able to see the two kind of usage chart. One is file usage activity, and which contains the file usages for every day. Maybe it gets, I think for now it gets updated once in a week, and you'll see the last 30 days or last 7 days or last maybe 3 months availability chart in the file by activity type in the home page dashboard. And you can filter it by using, there are 4 filters available in this chart. One is view or editor, or sync, shared internally, and shared externally. Currently, this chart in the current slide, I'll be able to, that is, you can able to view only the view or editor option. Because for last 4 or 5 days, I have worked on other syncing the documents or shared internally or externally, but it's not updated. Maybe I think it's updated maybe by today or tomorrow. That's what I initially told, it gets updated once in a week. Next one is site usage activity. This will show how many sites will be created or how many sites is actively viewable by users per day by day. So this also you can see it in the Admin Center, SharePoint Online Admin Center. Previously, if you want to view these activities, you need to go to Office 365 Admin Center. There, Office 365 Admin Center contains a lot of activities. It's not only contained the SharePoint Online activity, it contains other application activity also. But for SharePoint Online activity things, you can see it in the Admin Center itself. Next one is Site Collection Management. Previously, in the classic SharePoint Online Admin Center, you won't able to see the modern sites, modern teams or the modern communication sites. Okay, you will be only able to see the classic team sites, classic blank sites, site collections and all. So this is a lot, this is I think most of them are expecting this feature to be enabled as soon as possible, because we are unable to see the team sites or modern team sites and communication sites. So this is available in the Modern Admin Center. That is, we can create modern site collection. Previously, if you want to create a modern team site or communication site, you have to go to, that is, you have to go to SharePoint online site and /layout/sharepoint.aspx. That only you can create these sites from the only one place. Now you can also create that in SharePoint Admin Center. Previously, you won't able to create it. So we can able to create that from Admin Center. And next one is we can sort, we can filter, and we can do the basic sorting and filtering grouping options available in this admin center. Previously, we didn't have that kind of facility. The third one is we can have four different built-in views. We can it's like a normal list, so we can you can have change the view and you can see the information and all. And then last
can
one
you give, can we give the storage allocation for the cycle action over here, Santhakumar?
Storage allocation?
Yeah, quota for an each and every site collection.
Yeah, we'll be able to see. That is, we can add additional columns also to this view. So that's there. We'll check in the demo. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Okay. So we can also see the template type. Previously, we weren't able to see whether this site is created in what kind of template. Now we can able to see that option. Okay. The additional feature is the other option was we can have recycle bin for deleted site collection. We can manage the deleted site collection from the admin center. Previously, we don't have that kind of feature in as a out of box. We can do it in PowerShell and other coding stuff can be used to replace or revert that deleted site collection. Now we have it. And then there are other settings like whether the list on libraries will be shown visible in viewable in classic or modern. That is enabled in SharePoint Admin Center. This kind of this setting is already available in the classic thing, and they have moved those settings to modern Admin Center. Okay, this is a new admin URL. You have to go to layout/15/online/admin-home.aspx, which will open the modern admin center for you. Before that, you have to enable the first release settings, because currently these are available for first release users. Okay, we'll see the demo on that. Okay, so I'm going to SharePoint. This is Office 365 admin center. I'm going to just SharePoint Admin Center here. Currently, it is navigating to the classic SharePoint Online Admin. This is a classic Admin Center. You are unable, you can only able to see the classic site collections. Okay, and then you are here, you no need to, you are unable to filter or sorting anything. So I'm navigating to the new admin center now. So in the classic admin center, you can see the URL as like this, and then for a modern admin center, you can able to see this. So this is a SharePoint modern admin center. As you told, we have a short thing is available. This is built on developed based on the SharePoint framework, and then this chart is developed using a high chart JS file. So this is for additional information. Okay, so here I as I already told, if you click this option, this is like a filtering. So if you want to see the particular view or the edited chart view, so just click on this view or the editor, it will show you. And if you uncheck it, it will remove that. Like that, if you sync, if the documents are synced, or how many documents are synced, so those kind of details you will be able to get it. Shared internally, shared externally. So just click on that, it will filter a chart view. The same way, you can see if I click on this active sites, it is disabled at active sites. And from chart view, you can able to see only the total sites available. So these are things. So on October 9th, it's 17, and next day, October 16 is 19 total sites. Here you have only. So it is showing when per each day it is showing that the dot symbol. Okay. So if you need to view the detail about these activities, just click on this details. It is redirect you to the Office 365 Admin Center, There's a report usage dashboard is there. So it's loading. You can able to view the 30 days of file activity or 90 days file activity, 180 days. So everything you can able to see here, and you can export to Excel also. Same thing. Okay, and here you can able to see pages, users kind of activities from the Office 365 Admin Center. So the same way, if you have clicked on these details, this is also open the dashboard on Office 365 Admin Center as a SharePoint site usage. Previously, we have opened a file usage activity.
Can we get the file usage for a specific site collection or else for a web application?
This is for entire SharePoint Online tenant. You can get all, maybe after that you can just export to the Excel and you can filter it based on the site URL. Okay. So here you can see the details. From the details you can see the site URL. Okay. So
got it. Yeah.
You can also add the columns also here. The storage allocated as you asked by another person, and root web template and everything you can select here, and then you can export it. Okay. Yeah. So, and then any questions on this dashboard right now? Okay. So let's move on to the next one. Here we have another two webpages also there. One for Message Center and another one for Service Health. The Message Center, which is keep on updated. That is whenever a new feature is updated in SharePoint Online or going to update in SharePoint Online, the Office 365 team will update the information here. Okay, so in this today's session, we are going to view the feature is newly added or updated for last 2 months. So the next one is Service Health. Here we can see in the back end there is a timer job is running and it's checking the tenant service and all. So those kind of the Service Health advisory is available here. If you click on this, it is also open. Navigate to Office 365 Admin Center Service Health dashboard. You can see the detail about those Service Health information. Okay, it's navigating home Service Health. You can see there are two advisories for Exchange Online, like that one advisory for SharePoint Online. Okay, so you can just based on this you can fix this problem, or you can prepare yourself before having any major incident. Okay, so next we move on to SharePoint site management. You can see there are so much number of site collections created, but in a classic admin center you are able to see only the minimum number of site collections. But in SharePoint Modern Admin Center, you can see all kind of site collections created. Some of the site collections created from the Microsoft Teams, and some of the site collections will be created as a modern team site and then communication site, and some of the sites will be created from the Office 365 group. Okay, so everything will be listed here. So you can filter it based on template, the filter by template. I am going to filter it by communication site. These are all the communication site have already created. And then if you want to view as a team site, there you can see the team site classic experience and team site. This team site classic experience is the site collection is created from the old team site template. But this team site is referring to the modern team site template. So I'm clicking on this. So currently I have selected communication site and team site so that we are getting the both. So you here itself you can clear the filters and then filter it based on team site classic experience. Okay, clear. So like that you can add additional columns to this view. So you want to add a URL or the external sharing and files stored. And this will list out the total number of files is available in the site collection. The page is also the same kind of thing. And I'm applying this. So here you can see the details about the files available in the site collection. You can sort it. Okay. So
can I see here the storage quota?
Wait 1 second.
Storage quota.
Here there is no storage quota is available, but in the Office 365 admin center, also I think here your storage allocated. From the Office 365 admin center, you can able to see that detail, storage allocated.
Okay.
And then maybe it the storage quota, I think by soon they may be added that column also in this site collection. That is in this site management thing. These are, they all keep on adding or keep on updating the new feature to the SharePoint admin center. So maybe you can by soon you may expect that option also in this site management. Yeah. Okay. So whether we can also check whether the site is shared with the external users. So if you click on external sharing, and this will show the on or off options. So I'm going to select on. So these all the site collection is available for external sharing. So you can share the documents or files to the external users from these site collections. Okay, and then the next one is I'm going to show. So there is some relationship is in between the site SharePoint online site collection with the Microsoft team or Office 365 group. That also we can check it by using Office 365 group. If you have selected this, it will show the site collection. This will show these site collections are linked with the Office 365 group and the team, Microsoft Teams. So you can categorize everything from this site collection management itself. Previously in classic experience, we didn't have this option. Currently they provided. And previously we can use the PowerShell or REST API to get those things. Currently we have those settings as a out of box. Yeah, and you can also have a different type of views. You can select think post popular sites. It is showing page views 95. So this is a most popular site collection among all site collections. Okay, and then we'll go to recycle bin. This will show the deleted site collection from this. I'm just selecting this and then restore. That's it. Simple. Yeah. Vipin have asked one question, that is he is asking for me to show the first release settings. Yeah, I'll definitely show you once this settings the main demos is completed. I'll show you the how to enable the first release settings, and also I'll be showing how to enable the preview features settings. Okay, so we have enabled this. We have restored that site collection. We'll go and check it here. And yeah, here you can see this site collection is restored. And then there is another one option called email admins. That is email admins is nothing but whenever if you want to email the site collection administrator. Okay, so here from the SharePoint admin center itself, you can select all. If you want to send a separate email to all site collection admins, just enter the subject and message. It will send you the message to all site collection administrators. So you no need to send the mail or send any warning mail or send any information to site collection admin separately. So it's a bulk mail sending options there. I think I have another one question is raised. So what is the use of Teams app? Teams app is maybe it will be in future it will be replaced as Skype for business, or because the Microsoft Team is nothing but it's a single place there we can chat, or there we itself we can share the documents, there itself we can collaborate with all Office 365 applications. So it's, if you want to explain this Microsoft Teams, we need a separate session for this. Definitely I'll do a separate session by explaining Microsoft Teams. Maybe in the last, if I have enough time, I'll explain about the details on Microsoft Teams. Okay. The last option in SharePoint Online Admin Center is settings. Here, currently we are having two kind of settings. Maybe in future it will be added. There are a lot of settings going to be coming in. Will come in this settings page. So one is list and libraries. Here itself you can enable or disable the modern experience to a list in all site collections. So if you click on this off and click on save, in few minutes it will disable all the class, all the modern experience in all site collections. So currently I'm not going to do that. Okay, the notification, it's like the mobile push notification. If you enable this, you can get the mobile notification from your mobile. So it will enable this kind of settings to all site collections. We can also change the settings with respect to particular site collection. Okay, we can also do the restrict or enable or disable this kind of experience in particular site collection. Here you can globally disable or enable, but if you also enable or disable from site collection also, for site collection, when you go to site collection setting, there you can see that option. Here we can have another one option called OneDrive Admin Center. It also opens as OneDrive Modern Admin Center. Currently I'm not going to cover this. Okay, so if you want to go back to classic SharePoint Admin Center, below you can have this option, go to classic SharePoint Admin Center. If you click on this, it will navigate you to the classic SharePoint Admin Center. And if you want to go back, return back to Modern Admin Center, here you have this option, try the new SharePoint Admin Center. Yeah. Now we have completed feature. We have covered the features, currently available features in SharePoint Online Admin Center. Next, we'll see modern list experience. So I think the modern list experience is a list is enabled long ago. That is longer, maybe a year. But keep on, Office 365 team is keep on updating or keep on enabling the new features to the modern list and libraries. The first one is modern fundamentals. Here I think most of the settings is already available. You may be seen this feature also. We can sort, we can filter, and we can create a columns without navigating to the list settings or library settings page. From a single page itself we can do everything. Okay, and next one is we can also create a view, we can also manage the view or change the order of the view, order of the columns in a view, and we can filter and check the items and the everything. We can see it here. The next one is predictive indexing. This is most of them are expecting this kind of feature. That is, whenever the list item is exceed of 5000 items, you will get this this message, this ice cream bowl in the SharePoint Online. That is, it exceeds that threshold. So now the Office 365 team is reinvented this threshold, and they have provided this predictive indexing. That is, by default, if items exist more than 5000 of you, you will get this kind of bar, and then you won't be able to index a column afterwards. So if you want to index a column in a list, you have to do it before 5000 items. So this one, and then you can't be able to query more than this. If the threshold limit is crossed, you won't you can't get that you can't get the items based on the query by sorting or filtering and anything. So now predictive indexing in Office 365 or SharePoint Online, it supports that is the current modern list supports on 30 million items you can store in a list. Maybe you didn't get any threshold limit up to 30 million items, and paging is improved. That is, if you crawl scrolling, keep on scrolling the list, you will keep on getting the list items. Newly added list items will get populated. And indexing, current this predictive indexing is available for up to 19K items. That is, and then for now, this is available for this predictive indexing is available for 19,999 items, and maybe this more than 20K to 30 million items that predictive indexing will come for those items will be available maybe next year. And we'll see the demo demo about that predictive indexing. It is a cool feature now introduced. Okay, so next one is attention views. That is whenever we upload a document to the document library, okay, the document library has some mandatory columns. Okay, so whenever upload a document, we didn't fill those mandatory columns, and we never know there's a mandatory column is available or we have to fill that mandatory column. So to fix this problem, we recently received this attention views. You will get a new view in the views menu, that is files that need attention. If you click on that, it will show you the yellow ball like in the column, that is wherever you need to fill the value, that show the yellow background, and with is also called required info will be shown to you. So based on that, you'll know about we have to fill the mandatory column here. So you can go it and you can fill it there. Okay, so the red ball, the red circle in the view all before to the all documents, you can see the red ball. That's called a notification which shows there is here files that need attention views available here. If you didn't see that red circle, there is no mandatory columns we need to fill. We already filled that mandatory column, or there is no mandatory column in the library like that. Okay. Yeah, we'll see the demo about this too. Okay, I'm going to SharePoint on site. First, you'll see that predictive indexing. So I have already created one list with around 10K items. Okay, this index demo, you can see 9,770 items is there. I'm opening that index demo. So I didn't create any view or any, I didn't create or I didn't re-index anything right now. Okay. So this one will wait. We'll move on to list settings first. The settings, and you can see that the threshold is list is threshold is 5000. And click on indexed columns. You can see there is no index column. Index is created for any columns. So I'm moving back to the list. Here I'm going to I'm going to sort it based on is a 2A. So it's in a quicker second you can see this items. Okay, and I'm going to list settings. And to the index columns, you can see the project name is automatically indexed. Automate the artificial intelligence in the background which do the creation of index to the column automatically. So you no need to fear about the threshold limit or any querying settings if it exceeds more than 5000. So Go back to the index demo list. So I'm going to show you the paging, the scrolling. So currently I'm here, I'm just scrolling. Whenever I scroll to the bottom, it will keep on adding, populating the items. So if you scroll up to 9,000 items, you will get those items here. Okay, so you can see I'm still keep on getting the items. And if you want to filter it, yeah, you have commented this is a cool feature. Yeah, this is a cool feature, and I think most of them are expecting this kind of feature because I have a lot of the time I'm able to get this kind of question like whether we can index a column after it reaches a threshold limit. Maybe that's they want that to be need to be do in production side. So this feature I think solves that kind of issue. Yeah, and we can apply the filter also here. I think my network is slow, like the, I think. So we'll see. Oh, I think there is in the
Hey,
background some.
Bipin, I have one question.
Yeah.
Yeah, like we are using any view on any page using this list, any view of this list on a page. And sometime earlier, what used to happen, threshold cross, then it used to get break. So it won't happen in this use if we in this version.
Yeah, you won't get that kind of problem now. So you can
And
add
it
this
will
one.
automatically create the.
Yeah, it automatically do it. It's backend. There is artificial intelligence, the timer job is there that will do this kind of thing for us. So it's automatically index the columns. It if it reaches more than 5,000 items.
I have one other query on
Yeah.
this. Like, if I have a column where the things are not a unique, like data are not unique,
Okay.
although it has crossed the 5,000, will it create the index column on that?
Yes, sure. That is the currently how the index column, how the automatic index column work. No, that is if you sort the column, the automatic index will be autom the in the column will be automatically in added to the index columns by means of by sorting. So if you sort the column, it will automatically index for you. So there
Okay.
is no need to fear about the unique columns and thing. Currently, I think I have got another one query like so what happened when we add modern list as list view apart, will it be classic or modern? Currently, if you add a list view apart as a modern thing, you will never get this kind of problem. That is you automatically index on paging and the scrolling will work for populating all the items. But if you change it to classic experience, the paging scrolling will not work, but the indexing will work for you. Or the indexed column will automatically create it. For if you use a classic experience or modern experience. Maybe you can try it. Maybe if you try it or if you face any issue, just let me know. I'll fix for you. Okay. This automatic index will work for both classic and modern experience in SharePoint Online. Not in on-premise environment, this is all online. Maybe in future they will be move this feature to SharePoint 2016. Please also tell some limitation of a modern view as custom action, etc. Yeah, sure. Okay. Before that, here you can see it contains all kind of the filters for all columns. So you can just select it and you can apply that filter here. If I'm going to view only these two items, I'm just selected and then I click on. Okay. I just selected it here. Okay. You can see and we can also save it, this view from here itself. Save view as, all items save. Okay, here you can see now all items is only has these two items. Okay, and as I think one person have asked one question on this, Vipin Tyagi have asked, I have to tell about the limitation of modern view. Yeah, sure. Like in custom, in the classic experience, you can customize the view by adding or applying some by using XSL link or JS link, you can just do the customization to the list, and then you can add some lot of custom actions or context menu to your view. But in modern experience, you didn't get that option. Maybe my Office 365 team is keep on working on that feature to be enabled in this modern experience. And also another one, a cool feature, maybe I didn't have that feature enabled for you, and I'll be show something about column formatting. Okay, so in next few minutes. Okay, and then what I missed, I think you can create a columns from here itself, single line of text. If you click on the single line of text, you can see that option here. Just you can maybe single column, okay, and just save it, will be create a thing for you. Okay, and then if you enable this same, okay, and I'm also able to edit this column settings, edit more options, record this column contain information. Yes, I'm setting this column as a mandatory, and then I'm click on save. You can see this record info, you will able to get it. So I'm just click on this because this is a mandatory column, so it's asking us to fill the value for that. So I'm just going here, the item is missing record information, I'm entering just one. Okay, so it's saved, the record info is gone. And then here you can see this circle in all view options. It means we'll get this items that need attention. If you if you have mandatory column in document library, you will get the files that need attention. Okay, if I'm just selecting this, so it will show you the list of items which is required attention, like you need to fill the mandatory column like that. So that's it. I think it's taking some time because it's trying to load all 9000 items here, because so most only one item here filled a value, and a lot of all 9k items it's getting to load, so that it's getting some time. Maybe in the meanwhile, someone asked another question. If my list or library contains more than 30 views, then how the look and feel will be in modern view? In classic experience, we want to write some JavaScript to display all the view in single line. Here we can't, that is, here at present you didn't have option to write JavaScript to the view. Okay, instead of that, you can create a extension, SharePoint framework extensions. By using that SharePoint framework extensions, you can create some option in top of the page or somewhere else. Okay, and then you have maybe you can write a SharePoint framework web part to show that kind of information, and then you can add it here. But that is adding the additional web part to the list pages is not available yet. So maybe by soon you can add the additional web part to the this modern pages, list form pages. Yeah, you can see the single column is missing. It is available for all 9000 items. You can see if I scroll anything, so it lists out all the 9000 items here. The single column missing. Okay. And then, okay, got it. So this is okay. We have finished predictive indexing and. Okay, next one. Next one is the custom column format. In previous environment, we mostly anticipated like that is we have to customize the column in a list view, like just changing the color to the particular column value based on the column value. This thing. This most of now currently you are seeing the list view part which has some custom formatting is enabled. Okay, previously we have to do a JS link option to redo it, or we have to write a JavaScript by JavaScript and add it to list view page, and then we have to just do some JavaScript stuff here. So now we no need to do any that kind of additional effort to put everything. There is a currently we have out of box option is available. That is, we have to just do JSON based configuration option only. We have to apply it to that particular column setting. That is, if you click on that particular column in the context menu, you will get a format column like that. If you click on that, it will open your right side box, which will ask you to enter JSON configuration. In the JSON configuration, we have to enter what column you need to update and what kind of condition you have and how the particular column will look like. These are all you have to do it in that particular box. So maybe that also the Office 365 team is doing in the back end to automate generation of JSON configuration. So here you can in the below in the green color text you can see there is a link. If you go to that link, you can see the column formatting, the details about the column formatting, how we can format the column and everything. Currently, this is not enabled in my tenant. Maybe in the coming weeks, maybe within November end, it gets updated to all first release tenants. So you'll be do the hands-on by changing the format, changing the format of the column and everything. So this has some kind of limitation. It will not. That is, if you can't able to totally change the column format, if you want to totally change some kind of different column format, we have an option called field customizer that we can. Can we get short format in this? That's what I'm going to say. That is, if you want to do like that, enable the charting function to the column based on the column, you have to use field customizer. There is a field customizer, say one of the extension in SharePoint framework, so you can do it, and then you can do the complex stuff for formatting the column. Currently, we can do the changing the colors backend, or changing some kind of line, or adding icon, adding button. That kind of option is currently available by using the column format. By soon, maybe within this month, you'll get that kind of option in for the first release tenant users. Okay, you have to just click on the column and then column settings, format this column, and once you do that, you can get this right side the box. Here you can do the JSON configuration. So in the below link, you can get all kind of configuration option, what kind of configuration options we can do. So everything is available in this link. So just take the note of this, and you can just revisit this, and you can find the option for column formatting. And maybe once the column formatting is enabled for your tenant, just do the hands-on. Okay, so and then we'll go to sharing experience. This is another one. That is, we can currently we can enable the anonymous access to the SharePoint sites. That is, we can enable anonymous access, not to the entire site. We can enable anonymous access to particular files or items or particular set of document or library or list. Like that, we can enable. Okay, so because I think some month back, they have Microsoft Office 365 team has disabled that anonymous access to the SharePoint Online site. So, but now they have enabled this anonymous access to some kind of access to some kind of objects like list items or files or documents, libraries like that. Okay, so we can also enable or disable this anonymous access to the tenant. This from this picture I am saying that is this anyone which is source, we can have the option to share this link to external users. Okay, they no need to log in with Microsoft account or any live account, Hotmail account, no need. Okay, and this will send a link to that particular email ID, and there they have to do some validation, some verification is there. So they have to that verification is means they will get some kind of verification code. They have to enter that verification code when they ask. Once they enter, they will get the option to view that the particular document or particular item. So this is, we can limit up to 30 days. That is, we can enable that anonymous access link to up to 30 days from today. Okay, today is 4th November. And then so we can enable up to December 3rd. So after December 3rd, they didn't access that link. Okay, and this allow editing is available for, we can, if you select that allow editing, they can able to have that. Okay, this is expiry date restriction is limited to 30 days only. So you can't activate the link after 30 days. Okay, we'll see the demo now. Okay, I'm going to some article documents like this. Okay, so I'm going to some folder. Okay, and I'm going to share this link to external users, like maybe to my Gmail account. Anyone, I'm just disabling this allow editing, so it's available up to December 4th. Okay, and then anyone with link can view. Okay, so I'm just entering. It is kumar@gmail.com. Here you can get the warning message like kumar@gmail.com is outside of your organization. So we can add multiple email also here. So I'm entering, please check this document. Send. Okay, I'm getting okay, sure. I'll definitely answer you once our demo is over. So I have got some three kind of questions from Sujit, Vipin and Jayanti. So I'll definitely answer you. This will finish this demo now. Okay. So I have link is sent to this kumar@gmail.com. So I'm just navigating to sign in. I'm just signing into my Gmail account.
So. I got see Anta Kumar shared MS Ignite videos with you, so I'm just clicking that and I'm clicking on open. Okay, you see I got the I got access to that particular document. So like that we can enable anonymous links to multiple files or multiple items, so user can come and view that thing. Yeah, I'm in browser. Yes, I got a questionnaires.
Like, I have a question that
yeah.
Even if we put this document, if you put my email ID over there just right now,
okay.
Will I be able to access it?
Yeah, yes. Okay, on second.
Don't I need any user access or anything?
No need. That
or
is,
any,
that's what, when
now,
whoever has that link, they can view that information. That, one second, maybe I'll share that with you, maybe. Share. You can see anyone with the link can view and edit. So that is if I enable that edit option, you can able to edit. Okay.
Okay.
So if I, you now you can see anyone with the link can view. So if I provide the your email ID, definitely you can view.
Okay.
You want to view it? You want to test it?
Maybe you can give a link.
Okay.
It's JHH, no?
Okay. Okay. Just here I can give you. Okay. Apply. Give you the email ID. Maybe you can.
It's JHAJ.
J.
H A.
H A.
Dot Vikas.
Dot Vikas.
Vikas at outlook.com.
At.
Outlook.com.
Outlook.com. Right, okay.
We'll check it.
I'm just showing its outright send. Maybe you can test it and let me know. Okay, and another option I want to show you if you don't, that is admin, if the administrator wants to disable this anonymous link option, so that also we have the option there. So I'm going to that is Office 65 admin. Here we have settings, security and privacy, and then here we have an option called sharing. Click on edit. Have option here to change your external setting for SharePoint. You need to go to site settings. I'm just click on that. You can see anyone, including anonymous structure, is enabled. So I want to only existing external users is required. Okay. You can see only existing additional this is required, sign in required. So I'm just click on save. This is disable that anonymous access. I'm just click on save. The external sharing settings for sites is updated. Close this. I'm just coming back. Okay. Before that, you can check it. Because have you tested it?
I have tested it. I can see the document.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. Very good. It's a nice feature. This is also a nice feature because this feature also expected by most of us. Because if you want to share some document to external customer, they are not into our environment. But we want to share some information to the customer, and so this feature is nicely used. And then there is no duplicate by sending the email in or storing this document somewhere else. Yeah. And then here I want to just refresh this page. Just taking some time. Okay, I'm just clicking the same option. I'm just clicking the same option here, and then share. You can see only people in this is this tenant is registered in KTS Kumar Camp. So only people in KTS Kumar Camp with the link can view and edit. So anyone gets disabled now. So this we can also manage this kind of settings too. Okay, and then there is another one option called quick edit. I'm going to site content. Okay, and then I'm going to test list. One of my list. This contains some four or five values. Yeah, here I have added. So here you can have quick edit. So I think this quick edit you will be seeing your classic experience. So this kind of quick edit option is available in the classic experience too. But if you want to, if you are customized that new form or edit form in a customized form or customized view, that is, if you customize a new form, edit form, and then only the user is need to update the values from those forms. Okay, then there is no option for us to disable this quick edit from the classic experience like or modern experience. But we have the feature now, we can disable this quick edit option. Okay, and then we have also we can edit the values from this property pane. If you click on this, I can able to change my name here like this thing. Okay, so now we can also save the items from the property pane, and we can also save or edit the item from quick edit option. Okay, so if a form is customized, then we have to restrict in some way. We have to restrict this quick edit or property pane option in some way. So there comes behavior list settings. List settings, and then advanced settings. We have quick property editing. We can disable this. Just click on no. Now you won't able to see that quick edit editing to quick edit option. So I once discussed. Okay. Now you are unable to see that quick edit option here. And if I even select this and then property pane, all text fields are disabled. So only we can able to edit the item from the edit button by using edit option, or maybe if you are adding the new item or editing the item to through Power Apps. If we enable the option new editing or adding the items through Power Apps, we can disable it here, and only the users can add our items through Power Apps application. Okay, and if you are going to try with some backend mode, if you want to add items or edit the items through a backend mode without using any forms, this option is nice too. Nice option for it. Okay, and then the another one option is the main thing is the multi-factor authentication. So this feature is also recently released. That is, this is not only related to SharePoint Online, it is also related to the entire Office 365 applications. Like I'm going to Office 365 admin center and click on active users, and I am just selecting setup Azure multi-factor authentication. That is, this is enabling us to log in. This is a two-way, that is, two layer of authentication is required to log into the site. So here you can see I have a list of users and I have enabled this option. The multi-factor option is enabled for this particular test user one. Test user two is disabled, and for my account, this is disabled. This multi-factor authentication is disabled. Okay, so I'm just trying to log in with log into a SharePoint online site with test user one. So test user one. So I have entered it. It asking, you see, test user one at snips.it. It's asking for another one verification by calling to my mobile number. So once I have, yeah. Okay, I got the call now and I have answered it, and it asks us to click on hash symbol or star symbol, maybe it asks maybe hash. So it's hi one. Okay, we tried your call but didn't receive the response, so I'm going to try once again. So just wait for the call, waiting for a call. Okay, I got a call now. I'm answering it. Okay, I clicked on as. Okay. You see, this is a two way of authentication. So it's if you want to, yeah, it's we've been talking, as told, it's amazing. Yeah, it's a very amazing feature, so we can enable the two way of authentication here. Okay, then I think the experience is now done, and then now demo on other updates. You see, SMS features are also available. I checked that, but I didn't have that SMS feature option is enabled on this multi-factor authentication. So maybe in future, maybe I have missed, maybe it will be enabled in future. So other updates, so we'll be check what are the updates. Yeah, thanks, Vignesh. Vignesh have told this feature is available, so I think we'll get the SMX also. Office 65 updates. So this is, I have created one list. There I have listed updates for last 2 months. So I'm just group by category. It has. So we are only going to check the SharePoint online updates now. So I'm just sorting order to newer. So in the Office 65 now we can able to add or that is we can use the hash or percentage symbol for creating the documents in SharePoint online and OneDrive. That's what it's going to say. Yes, we can now able to do that option. Okay, and we are removing Visio Web Access. Yes, Visio Web Access is going to remove from SharePoint Online. Instead of that, we will be getting the Visio Online Services, Visio Services. That is, we have a file viewer web port in SharePoint Online. By using that, we can view that Visio file in that file viewer web port. Okay, and then simplified, yeah, secure external sharing. That's what we have done. This simplified, that is anonymous access and everything. So we have done attention views. I think this also we have we had a demo on this flow launch panel. Yeah, we can check it now. That is, if I click on this flow, create a flow. Previously, if you click on that create a flow, it navigates to the flow flow page, that is flow application. Now, but now we are getting that flow options here itself. So if you click on that, we can create a flow. It will navigate to the flow application. There we can add our activities or conditions to run the create a flow, and it run as a workflow to the particular item. Okay, so it's selected. Send a customized email when a new SharePoint list item is added. Currently, I'm not going to show this demo right now. Maybe in future, if I get the time or if I get the opportunity, I'll definitely provide an option. And we also have this for SharePoint, that is for Microsoft Flow or Microsoft Power Apps. I think we already done some kind of webinars to this one. So you have those videos on the YouTube. So maybe we'll, once this is over, we'll share that video also to you for Microsoft Flow and Microsoft Power Apps. Okay, and then the next one is quick edit list enhanced for custom forms. Yes, this is also we have gone through. And forms panel in modern list and custom forms. Okay, this forms panel, that is currently, if you want to there is no customization option for changing the new form or the edit form right now. Okay, maybe that is this feature is not enabled to my tenant also. If I had it option, definitely I'll provide that. That is, if you have click on this Power Apps, you can have a option called custom form like that. Okay, maybe you will get another option about to that create an app. If you click on that, it will open a right side panel. In the panel, you can have an option to customize the, that is, you can have the option to customize the form from the Power Apps. So currently, if you can customize the form for the mobile view and tablet view alone. For if you want to customize the form for desktop view, you will definitely by soon you will get, maybe within November or within December, you will get that option to customize the new form, edit form from the for a desktop view. So advanced data governance. There's a one whenever you can see there is, we have the property. Okay, I didn't get it. Okay, I'm going to another one list. Site contents, demo list. Okay, that is this is representing event based retention. Check that option. Okay, here also you didn't get that option. That is, there is a compliance asset ID. Another one column will be added to our list. That is a hidden column and it's a non-mandatory column. Okay, so whenever that is based on that compliance asset ID, that is a that is removal of document or removal of item, that triggering the compliance feature will be triggered based on that compliance asset ID. That's what event based retention is representing. So it's a compliance feature, it's enabling the compliance feature. Another one is column formatting in SharePoint Online. This feature is not available till now in my tenant. Maybe it's get, they are keep it will be maybe within, before this month you will get this option, formatting the columns in SharePoint Online for columns. And create currency fields in modern SharePoint list. Currently you didn't have this creation of currency field from the modern view. If you want to create a currency field right now, you have to just navigate to list settings. There you can create a column. But for from the page itself, if you want to create a new column, you don't have that option right now. So maybe in this list, we'll get that currency field option here by soon. And there is next one, another important feature, site collection app catalog. Currently, if you are deploying the SharePoint framework solutions, you need to go to Tenant or App Catalog. There only you have to deploy it, and it is that will enable for entire tenant. Okay, you can't control it from site collection level. But the site collection app catalog is going to introduce by soon. From the site collection app catalog itself, you can control that what are the SharePoint frameworks you want to visible viewable in particular site collections. And reports on modern SharePoint online pages. There are like file viewer and some. I think maybe I'll show you that. If I'm going to home page, you can see the home page. You can see updated feature in the message center. You can get this. So these are the new reports is going to be available by soon. Currently we have file viewer report now, and it supports 270 plus file types. You can view any kind of files from that file viewer report. So you can, that is the Visio web apps report will be replaced by this by using this file viewer report. So these are the reports will be available by, these are the reports will available by soon. Maybe will be completed November, in early November, and rollout will be completed by end of December. Okay, and then the next feature one is last feature is it's they have updated November 1st. That is they are going to roll out this Power Apps and Flow integration out of preview. So you won't currently it is in a preview mode, and soon they will be remove this options from preview mode. Once this preview mode is disabled, you didn't get this flow options and create a power apps option from this modern list actions command bar. Okay, so to get that, if you have your license, you'll get this option. If you didn't have that license, you didn't get this flow and the power apps options here. Okay, so okay, now I'll show how to enable this first release option to the tenant. This I am in currently Office 365 admin center. I'm going to just settings, security and privacy. Okay, sorry, I missed it. Setup. Click on under the settings. You have your organization profile. From the organization profile, you have option called release preferences. Here you have edit, and you can select first release for everyone. If you no need, if you want to restrict this first release for some users, you have to just select first release for selected users. Click on next. Select people to receive updates. Yes. Okay. It's not. Okay. Okay. It's keep on loading here. So that is here itself. You have to select this act, this edit, and then first release for everyone. Just next. And then yes, this will enable the first release for everyone, every user. Okay, so yeah, any okay next so any questions? So I'll take that command section. I got some questions. Is access restriction possible at column level since we cannot use JavaScript also in view page? Maybe can, so maybe we can if you go with if you go with the in the we have this kind of option in if you create a custom form, custom new form or edit form through Power Apps, we can restrict it, restrict the column. Okay, if you want to just disable that view, only want to like if you want to so it's a column restriction. We can do it. Maybe you can. That is, you can disable that quick edit and property panel edit. And you can, if you are going to use a custom form for saving this, you can do it from backend, or you can do it by using form using the Power Apps. Okay, like view edit and for how many days? Subscribe VPN. Yeah, this sharing feature is only limited up to 30 days. Okay, and Jayanti have asked, could you please explain time store management, how it works in modern view? I think it will take some additional time for me, so maybe I'll Jayanti, can you just ping me later or through call? I'll explain you on that. Maybe I'll have a separate session for this too. Okay. Yeah, sure. I'll share a PPT and video once this is completed. Maybe you'll expect those links maybe tomorrow, early tomorrow morning. Okay, so any questions? Okay, so I think I have responded to the answers from the chat. Okay, so if you have any questions, yeah, see you also. Thank you. Thanks for the comment. Yeah, if you have any queries, you can directly call or ping me. Okay, before that, I getting another one comment question here. How to add custom CSS and JavaScript in modern page? This is not recommended by Microsoft to add this custom CSS or JavaScript in modern page. But the Microsoft team is working on that by enabling this custom CSS and JavaScript to the modern pages. So maybe we'll expect this kind of feature maybe for next year, or maybe not. Okay, for that, instead of the custom CSS only, they have provided a lot of the customized feature in out-of-box mode. You can have column format and field customizer, and then you can have attention view. Like that, you can have lot of these sort of things we have previously customized, but now these features are available as a out of box. Okay, maybe Microsoft is keep on listening to us through, I think, user voice. There is a user voice, the site in Microsoft is having some user voice site there. We can provide what are the things we required. So if you post it there, they will have some kind of votes, higher votes. They will keep they will definitely look onto that this kind of information, these kind of features. Okay, so yeah, I think thanks Ramakrishnan for your comment. Thanks Jayanti for the nice comments. Yeah, if you want to just contact me, just you can reach me on ktskumar.com, and you can subscribe on YouTube channel, maybe in the name of KTS Kumar. This is a URL for my YouTube channel, and you can just ping me or comment me, or you can raise any questions to Twitter, Skype, Facebook, Skype in the name of KTS Kumar. Okay, so I think if you didn't have any questions right now, maybe we'll close it. So first, thanks to the CSOP Corner for the us organizing this webinar, and also thanks to Chennai Chapter Lead Santok Mamunuswamy for it. And you can just catch me on any social media in the name of KTS Kumar. Thanks everyone, thanks for watching, and sure maybe I'll see you in next webinar, and maybe very soon. Thank you once.